Good morning all of you. In the previous class we have discussed some important topics like what is meant by law of reflection, what is meant by law of refraction, and how they are useful for understanding the total internal reflection. We haven't started total internal reflection till now. Before that, there is a scientist called as Snell. He proposed one simple law called as Snell's law. Okay, so based upon the law of reflection as well as law of refraction, the Snell proposed Snell's law. So Snell's law states that the ratio of sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of the angle of refraction is constant. The ratio of sine of the angle of incidence and the sine of the angle of refraction is a constant. Okay, so this is what is the equation for the Snell's law. Okay, so for example, N1 is the refractive index of the one medium, the incident angle say theta 1, okay, we have taken sine of incident angle, the say sine theta 1 is equal to the next medium or the other medium whose refractive index is N2 and sine of refracted angle say theta 2. Okay, so Snell proposed this equation to find the total internal reflection as well as some important topics to understand the total internal reflection like acceptance angle, numerical aperture, like that. You can understand here N1 and N2 are the refractive indices of two media, theta 1, theta 2 are the incident and the angle of refraction of the two media. Okay, so what is total internal reflection? So we are discussing about the propagation of light in an optical fiber. So how the light propagate? Okay, so the light should be launched from one end into the optical fiber, where inside the core the light should be directed inside the core. So light should be traveling inside the core till the end of the cable, till the end of the cable. So like this. Okay, so whenever you launch the light into the, say this is the optical fiber, so light should travel like this, okay, inside the core. The light should not penetrate into the cladding and it should not go outside the core. Okay, if it happens, there will be a loss of information, means the light should be totally reflected into the core only. It should not go outside the core, or there should be no refraction at all. There should be no refraction at all. Okay, so this kind of concept where the light totally reflects in the core and propagates till the end of the optical fiber cable is called as total internal reflection. Is called as total internal reflection. In order to happen this total inside the core of an optical fiber, there is a simple concept, this already we have learned in the previous session. It is called as critical angle. Okay, what is critical angle? The angle of refraction, okay, the angle of refraction for which the angle of incidence, the angle of, What is critical angle? If the refractive angle, what is critical angle? The refractive ray or the refracted ray, if it is making 90 degrees, if it is making 90 degrees with the normal, The corresponding incidence angle is called as. This is what we have learned in the previous session. So there is a. If you go to the previous session, you can see here. You can see here. The incident ray, the ray is incident here. Okay. So some part of the light got reflected, some part of the light got refracted. Okay. So there should be no refraction at all. There should be no refracted angle at all, or the refracted ray should completely bend into the same medium. That is called total internal reflection. You can see here total internal reflection. I have explained that in three figures. Figure 1, figure 2, and figure 3. You can see here I have taken two media, water. Okay, you can observe the light is launched from the water at the surface or the interface between the air and water. Some part of the light got reflected, very small amount of light got reflected, we are calling it as weak reflection. Most of the light got refracted, that is penetrated from or traveled from denser medium of our water into the rarer medium or air. Okay, so this is the first diagram. You can observe the refraction. This is refracted ray. What I have done is I have changed the angle of incidence. This is I. I have changed the angle of incidence. I have increased the angle of incidence. Okay. Such that the refracted ray is bending away from the. This is normal. Okay. The refracted ray is bending away from the normal and making 90 degrees. And making 90 degrees with the normal. Okay. The corresponding angle of incidence is called as critical angle. The corresponding angle of incidence is called as critical angle. Okay. You see the third figure. You see the third figure. I have increased the angle of incidence more than critical angle. I have increased the angle of incidence more than critical angle. Okay. What happens here? The same refracted ray is completely bent into the same media, that is water. Okay, the same refracted ray, this is in the part 1, in the first figure, there is a refracted ray in the second figure, refracted ray is traveling along the air and water interface. In the third figure, the refracted ray is traveling inside the water, or you cannot call it now it as refracted ray. You can call it as reflected ray only. You can call it as reflected ray only. Because you can see this is the incident ray which is propagated at the interface of the air and water. What has happened? What happened here? The same ray is completely reflected back into the same medium. Okay, there is no refraction at all. So completely the incident ray is completely reflected back into the same medium. When? What is the condition? When the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. When the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, what is happening here? The incident ray is completely reflected back into the same media. Means there is no refraction. There is no refraction. The ray is completely, totally reflected into the same media. That is the reason this kind of phenomenon is called as total internal reflection. This kind of phenomenon is called as total internal reflection. This is very much required. This principle or this phenomenon is very much required in optical fiber communication system. As I said earlier, the optical fiber, consider this is the optical fiber, this is clad, this is core clad, this is core, okay. It is falling somewhere here from externally. I have projected the light into the core. What should happen? Light should refract and strike at certain point at core cladding interface, and light should not go into the clad. It should come again to the core. Okay, so again here it should hit it at some particular point at core cladding interface. It should go back and hit again at the core cladding interface, and this process should continue till the end of the fiber, till the end point of the optical fiber. Got it? Okay, so if you observe here, the light which is projected from the outside medium entered into the core and completely reflected in the same medium, in the core. It is not going outside the core. Okay, it is completely going inside the core. You can observe, this is the incident ray, this is the reflected ray, this is the incident ray, reflected ray. Complete reflection only happening, there is no refraction. Okay, then only the light from one end will travel to at the another end. So this is called as total internal reflection, and based upon this total internal reflection only, the communication of light or the traveling of light from one point, that is transmitter, to another point, that is receiver, occurs in optical communication system. Okay, based upon this concept, you can see some pictorial representations here. Three figures I have, very good figures I have given here. All represent total internal reflection only. Okay, see the first one. The light is traveling from one point of the optical fiber. Okay, light is traveling from one point of the optical fiber. It is hitting at certain particular point. Okay, it is going to the core cladding interface, again hitting, again going to the core cladding interface. Like this, the total internal reflection is taking place. See the second point, the same thing here. Okay, so this is the cladding, outside medium is the cladding, the inside medium is the core. You can observe the light which is falling at the core cladding interface, hitting into the same media, that is core. There is an experimental setup actually. There is an experimental setup. See this figure, experimental setup. I have taken a bucket. I have poured benzene into that benzene. Okay. So what I have done is, at two ends, okay, what I have done is, I have made two points. At two ends, I have made two points, say A and B. At point A, I have projected a laser light, and opposite to the point A, that is at point B, I have made a small hole such that this liquid benzene should come outside the through that hole. If you observe, we all know that the laser is the light which is having high directivity. It is high directional light. Okay, actually the light should move in this direction like this. Actually, the light should move from point A, striking the point B, and in a straight line like this. But if you observe, the light is not moving in the straight line. It is moving along the liquid or the benzene which is flowing out from the hole. hole. Okay, what is the reason here? What is the reason? Here, the density of benzene and the density of outside medium are not same. The density of the benzene and the density of the outside medium are not same. Okay, so whenever the what is the condition for you can the, why what is the reason why it is happening like that means there are conditions for total to happen total internal reflection. Okay, one is the incident angle should be greater than critical angle, that we already know. Incident angle should be greater than critical angle, then only total internal reflection takes place, that we already observed that. The second one is light should travel from higher refractive index material, light should travel from higher refractive index material to the lower refractive index material, or in other words from high dense medium to low dense medium. Two conditions should satisfy for the occurrence of total internal reflection. One is angle of incidence should be greater than a critical angle. The second one is the light should propagate or travel from high dense medium to low dense medium, or you can say from higher refractive index material to lower refractive index material. Okay, now see this experimental setup once again. The light is traveling from benzene, it is traveling from benzene. Okay, where it is going? It is going outside. The medium is air. Here the refractive index of benzene is higher than the refractive index of air. That is the reason, that is the reason light is traveling along the path of benzene. Light is traveling along the path of benzene. Okay, like this. Light is traveling along the path of benzene. This is the laser light which is traveling along the path of the liquid benzene. Actually, the light should go like this. It is a laser light which is having directivity, very high directivity. Light should go like this. It will not go. Why? What is the reason? Because it is projected into the medium, that is benzene, whose refractive index is very much high compared to the refractive index of air. So along the benzene, along the this liquid, flow of liquid, light also will propagate. This is the experimental dark room experimental setup to understand total internal reflection in an optical fiber. Okay, so how to find the critical angle? How to find the critical angle? Again, from the Snell's law, the known law is Snell's law. So what it states? The product of refractive index of the medium into the sine of angle of incidence is equal to the product of refractive index of another medium sine of angle of refraction. Okay, n1 sin theta 1 is equal to n2 sin theta 2. Okay, so but the angle of incidence is equal to critical angle. Okay, when the refraction angle is equal to 90 degrees, when the refraction angle is equal to 90 degrees, the angle of incidence you are calling it as critical angle. Okay, so here theta 2 is the refraction angle, it is 90 degrees, and the theta 1 is the incidence angle, it is for the corresponding incidence angle is called as critical angle. So n1 into sin theta c is equal to n2 into sin 90, or you can write sin theta c is equal to sin theta c equal to n2 by n1, however sin 90 is 1. This is how you can find the critical angle, say theta c, or you can write theta c equal to sin inverse of n2 by n1. Sin inverse of n2 by n1 is called as critical angle. Okay, this is how you are going to find the critical angle inside the optical fiber cable. The next important concept, interesting concept is acceptance angle. Okay. So what is acceptance angle? So it is the maximum angle at the launching end, that is outside the optical fiber. Okay, it is the maximum angle done by the incident ray, okay, for which the refracted ray is making 90 degrees with the normal, for which the refracted ray inside the optical fiber is making 90 degrees with the normal. So that kind of maximum incidence angle at the launching end is called as acceptance angle. Is called as acceptance angle, or you can write the maximum angle at which light entering the core is transmitted through the fiber and propagated without being refracted. Okay, is known as acceptance angle. Okay, so there is an equation for this. Theta max is equal to, that is theta max or I max or theta m. There are different notations for acceptance angle. Theta max equal to sine inverse of root of n1 square minus n2 square. Okay, based upon this acceptance angle only, there is another small concept called as numerical aperture. Numerical aperture means light gathering capability of the optical fiber. Light gathering capability of the optical fiber is called as numerical aperture. It is NA equal to sine theta max. It is taken from the acceptance angle only. Okay, NA, numerical aperture, equal to sine theta max, that is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. Okay, so now let us see how the acceptance angle theta max equal to sine inverse of root of n1 square minus n2 square. Okay, how this equation is achieved. Okay, now let us derive that on the board.